गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू अन अकेडमीज यूट्यूब चैनल। लेट्स क्रैक यूपीएससी सीएससी इंग्लिश। एज यू नो, वी आर डूइंग ए कंप्लीट कवरेज ऑफ ज्योग्राफी कोर्स। एज पार्ट ऑफ दैट, टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट फैसिनेटिंग एस्पेक्ट ऑफ यू मॉर्फोलॉजी, कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट थ्योरी। सो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट दैट इन डिटेल। सो हाउ दिस ड्रिफ्ट हैपेंड, what is the theory, what are the evidences which supporting this theory, how this theory has failed, all these things we'll be discussing in detail. Before that, few lines about Unacademy platform. So Unacademy learning platform, this is the largest platform available online for cracking UPSC CSE. And once you subscribe, what will you get? What are the advantages? You will get access to daily live classes. You will get access to such structured courses which are in tune with the UPSC syllabus. You also have batch courses of late started for the freshers, where everything A to Z of preparation will be done in these batch courses. Okay, so batch courses are one of the most unique things. We're going to start batch courses on June 15th itself. So this is the time where you can enroll into the subscription. You will get live tests and quizzes, where will be proper evaluation will be there regularly, unlimited access to all the live and the recorded courses from the comfort of any of your devices, and you can watch any number, n number of times. So many times videos, they are asked to study only once or twice. But here you can watch it n number of times. Then, so what this you can watch, you can when you subscribe, you are just subscribing not just to my own course, you are subscribing to every educator's course, some of the educators here. Then you can see in the app and the website, you can see all the courses are organized in a fashion which you can choose whichever you want. And here lies the flexibility for you. Flexibility by time and flexibility by course. And these are the batch courses which are the unique ones which I am trying to tell you. And coming to the subscription, you have a range of options from 1 month to 24 months. We would suggest you to always go for 12 and 24 months. You can see this. 12 month is highlighted and 24 months is highlighted here. The simple reason, it is for to cover the vast syllabus. Nobody has done it in a very, very short period of time. You need time to give yourself to understand the entire syllabus, to cover it, to grasp those things, to understand certain topics which are difficult. You can rewatch. So for these things, we would suggest you to go for 12 and 24 months. And some people will go for 1 month simply to check the Unacademy. Instead of that, we would ask you to, instead of using for 1 month, watch special classes which are free for you. That would be much better. And before that, you can add this code VE10, where you will get 10% discount. So your 12-month subscription will come at a very, very cheap price of 39,600 rupees. And your 24-month subscription, which costs 64,000, use code VE10, you'll get 10% discount, that becomes 57,600. So these are the advantages which you'll be having out. Moving forward, so this, please remember the cost effectiveness of 12 months and 24 months. You can see it is very cheaper in 12 and 24 when compared with others, right? That's where we would suggest you to go for these long-term packages. Look at the difference between 6 months and 12 months. So these are the things which I would like to tell you. So let's start. Yes, good evening all of you. Good evening Srihari, Hemant, Arun, Mastan. Yes, I am from Hyderabad and my native is, my language is Telugu. Yes. Okay. So let's watch this video. A GIF, not a video. It's a GIF. You see this, how the continents have separated. To understand, it's not an exact one, but just to understand. Okay, so based on this, what does this continental drift theory suggest? So it's a very unique one, continental drift theory. So this drift theory, back then, as I told you, geomorphology, the study of land, the first and unique thing which you find on the earth's surface is distribution of oceans and continents. Why are they distributed in this fashion? That is the first question which a geographer, geomorphologist should answer. Why the continents and oceans are distributed in the present fashion? So if you see a world map, why it is located? So this is the first thing which they understand about distribution of ocean and continent. So one of the ancient theory and the first theory which was suggested is called continental drift theory, which deals with the distribution of oceans and continents. This is how geologists thought continents moved over time. And who proposed this? One of the most prominent one is Alfred Wegener, 1912. He proposed in the year 1912, Alfred Wegener. But his idea is itself is based on Abraham Ortelius in 1596, before which was developed by Wegener later on. So the concept is provided by Abraham Ortelius, and later on Alfred Wegener, he has developed the concept in a much more organized manner. Then, but is this continental drift theory successful? No. Why successful in the sense, is the entire theory correct? No. Why? Because plate tectonics theory, which was developed post 1950s and 1960s, that has slowly changed the aspect of everything here. Okay, so plate tectonics theory, that has changed the entire aspect. But more than that, why this theory is important and all these things, we will start in detail. So as of now, what is continental drift theory? It deals with the distribution of oceans and continents. So they say that continental landmasses were drifting across the earth, sometimes plowing through oceans and into each other. What is that? Continental landmasses were drifting across the earth, sometimes plowing through oceans and into each other. This movement is called by Wegener as drift, continental drift. So according to this theory, there was one big landmass called Pangaea, which was covered by one big ocean called Panthalassa. So Pangaea means complete land, Panthalassa means complete ocean. And these two are separated by a sea, small minor sea called Tethys Sea. And this divided the Pangaea into two land masses called Laurentia to the north, Gondwana land to the south of the Tethys Sea. So the present Europe, North America is Laurentia, and South America, Africa, India's landmass, Australia, is Gondwana land. So Laurentia to the south and to the north, and Gondwana land to the south of the Tethys Sea. You can see here, this is, you see, first one, Pangaea, surrounded by a land called Panthalassa. In between you are having this sea called Tethys Sea. So this segregated Pangaea into two, Laurentia and Gondwana land. So Laurentia is present North America, Greenland, Europe, Gondwana land, Africa, South America, Australia, Antarctica, Indian landmass. And this, which started around 215 million years ago, from there, slowly, it developed into the present patterns. So once Laurentia and Gondwana land were segregated, each of the Laurentia and Gondwana land are segregating, and slowly we are finding the present pattern. Have you observed this movement here? You see here, Red Sea, here they are intact, and now here they are not intact. In future, we don't know. There might be another kind of thing here. So along Lake Victoria, there might be another aspect. So this movements of continents, which are across the world, is called continental drift theory. So you see this video again. You can see here there is a drift happening here. This drift has started, and there is also a possibility in the future. You see, this is India, which is moving towards sin. So once upon a time India was not part of it. Slowly it is moving, and similarly here you see there is also a possibility that this part also might break away in the future. Possibility. So the continents are drifting away. You see, even the North America and Europe, they are drifting away by 2.5 centimeters every year. Even now Indian landmass is moving by 1 centimeter per year. So you are observing Indian landmass moving towards north, and North America is moving towards west. Why they are moving? There are many factors for it. So all these things is what is called continental drift theory. So what is that? Now, what is the hypothesis of this theory? According to this theory, 200 million years ago, Pangaea started splitting and broke down into two large continental masses as Laurasia and Gondwanaland, forming northern and southern components. Subsequently, Laurasia and Gondwanaland continued to break to form smaller continents that exist today. So the present Earth surface which you see, present continent which you see, has been developed by subsequent divisions of Laurasia and Gondwanaland, which themselves have been separated from Pangaea. So this is the context. Now, what evidence this theory says? This is the most important one. One of the first evidence is the jigsaw effect. Okay, evidence in support is jigsaw effect. Or rather, what you call the matching of continents. So the matching of continents or the jigsaw effect. You can see here, South, this is South America. Left side, South America. This is the Brazil plateau. And this is Africa. And you can see the bulge of Africa here around the Guinea coast. And the Brazilian bulge and the depression along the Guinea coast, if they move together, it is a matching of the continent. So, you know, jigsaw effect, you heard this word jigsaw puzzle. What you do? You try to pick the pieces and put into a full length thing. So, the present Earth surface, the present distribution of a continent is all about these things only. So if you keep the entire present continents, it is nothing like a jigsaw puzzle. The once you affect it, it will be fixing together exact. One of the best example is Brazil and Africa. Similarly, Greenland. You see, Greenland puts into Hudson Bay here. This is Hudson Bay of North America. Greenland can enter into here. So everything, all things, if they pull up together, they'll form one big landmass. That's what the theory suggests. One of the biggest evidence of continental drift theory is this. Not just that, there are so many other evidences. What other evidences you have? One of the evidence you have is till deposits. Tillite. Tillite is nothing but till deposits. Now, what is till? You have glaciers. The deposition of glaciers are called till. Just like you have deltas, the deposition of rivers are called deltas. Very similar to that, there is also a deposition of glaciers which are called till deposits, which are nothing but sedimentary rocks formed out of deposits of glaciers. These things are found across Africa, Falkland Island. Where is Falkland Island? Can anybody explain? Where is Falkland Island? Yes, mention in the chat section. Very quickly, Falkland Island, it is around Argentina, South America. South America, Atlantic Ocean. So, Africa, Falkland Island, Madagascar, Antarctica, Australia, all are discussing about paleoclimates. Paleoclimates, where Falkland Island and paleoclimates, where you are having glaciers. Simple point is, the kind of deposits which you found across all the places are one and the same. It indicates that these deposits are formed by similar glacier in the past. That is what till deposits say about. Till deposits, what do they say? Similar deposits which are found across the continents is what is called till deposits. Not just that, you also have gold deposits which are called placer deposits. The occurrence of rich placer deposits of gold where in the coast of Ghana in West Africa, and the absolute absence of source rock in the region is an amazing fact. So you have gold deposits in Ghana coast, but there is no evidence of the source rock in this region. But the veins, what are veins? Nothing but the, just like how you have blood vessels, very similarly that the chambers where magma is entering from the mantle into outer space, into the earth's surface from the interior of the earth, we call them as veins, the lines. These veins are found in Brazil. So that means that once upon a time, the gold bearing veins are in Brazil, and it appears that gold deposits of the Ghana are derived from Brazilian plateau when the two continents lay side by side. So this is what they say about placer deposits. That means what? Simply, the source regions of gold deposits are in Brazil, whereas the deposits are actually in Ghana. This indicates that once upon a time they were together. Then one of the most important aspect, distribution of fossils. Now what is distribution of fossils? Distribution of fossils says, when identical species of plants and animals are adapted to living on land in fresh water, they are found on either side of the marine barriers. What are found? They are found on either side of the marine barriers. Marine means what here? Ocean. An example, lemurs occur in India, Madagascar, Africa. Mesosaurus was a small reptile adapted to shallow brackish water. So that is found in South Africa and Brazil. You can see the example here. You see here. This is South America and Africa, blue color one. South America and Africa. So what do you find? A reptile by name Mesosaurus, crocodile. Mesosaurus. Similarly, and another land reptile fossils called Cynognathus. This is found, this is another reptile which is found between South America and Africa. Similarly, fossil evidences of another reptile, Lystrosaurus, which is found across Africa, Madagascar, India, Antarctica. And then the green color indicates the flower called Glossopteris, which is found across all the continents almost. Are you getting this aspect? So what is simply one? Fossil evidences of plants and animals which are adapted in either side of the ocean. Marine barriers means ocean barriers. So this also is one of the evidence. Not just that, there is one more evidence. Rocks of same age across the oceans. The belt of ancient rocks of 2000 million years from Brazilian coast matches with those of Western Africa. The earliest marine deposits along the coastline of South America and Africa are of the Jurassic age. This suggests that the ocean did not exist prior to that. Did not exist prior to that time. This suggests that the ocean did not exist prior to that time. So what we are saying, the rocks of same ages are found across the world. This also suggests that the rocks are there. The ocean did not exist, and there once upon a time one and the same. Now, is it clear all of you until now why continents have drifted? Yes, is it clear, all of you? Shall I move forward? Okay, moving forward. So now that we have seen that the continents have been drifted and there are some evidences which are completely true, but the first thing is you need to ask why it has been occurred, why the continents are drifted. According to hypothesis of this theory, that the continental drift theory stipulated by Alfred Wegener, he says that the first of all the continents are moving in two directions. Which directions? Two directions. What are the two directions? One is towards westwards. Example, North America. You see North America. North America has drifted away from Greenland, Europe. That is the reason why Greenland is there and North America is moving towards west. Similarly, India moving towards equator in the past and now in general we can say moving northwards. So once India was segregated, India was in the southern hemisphere when it is part of the Gondwana land. India was in southern hemisphere once it was separated. So as it was separated, it slowly started moving northwards from Gondwana land. So this is what is the why continents have drifted. The tidal force of the moon and to lesser extent the sun also played a major role, westward drift. So this is what the thing. First of all, the directions. What are the directions? Westwards and northwards. Then what is the reason for this westwards and northwards? According to the west wind drift, the westward drift like North America, it is because of tidal force of the moon and the lesser extent sun. So tidal force is played a major role. This is what the continental drift theory says that. And there is also another force called polar fleeing force. What is this force called? Polar fleeing force. What is this polar fleeing force? It is related to the rotation of the earth. We all know that the earth is not a pure sphere. It has a bulge at the equator and this bulge is due to rotation of the earth. Because of the bulge at the equator, what happens is there is a centrifugal force which is caused by rotation which is more at equator. Because there is centrifugal force which is caused by the earth's rotation, there is a northward migration of the or equatorward migration initially. That's what Alfred Wegener has said. You see, don't ask me questions, sir, how it is happening, how tidal force, gravitation pull of the moon is so huge. Don't ask me that. Ask Alfred Wegener. Huh? So what you're saying, according to this theory, he says so. And he says that just like how a ship is floating in the ocean, the continent is also moving in the ocean. This is because of the rotation of the earth. That's what the continental forces he has suggested. Now, are these forces practically true? Are these forces practically true? You tell me. Tidal force? Can a tidal force, a gravitational pull of the moon, can drift the entire continent? You tell me this. The force of the moon is not as big to pull the continental, to put the continents across the oceans, right? So this way, this continental forces which he has said. Now, what are the reasons according to the how do they move? They move westward side, they move northward side. Westward side is because of tidal force. Northward side is because of polar fleeing force, which is nothing but simple way centrifugal force of earth's rotation. That's why I have identified here. Centrifugal force of the earth's rotation. That's you remember. So because of these forces, the continents are moving apart, moving northwards. But this is not true. The later evidences like plate tectonics, further concepts like sea floor spreading, all these things have clearly suggested that continents have not been drifted in this way. They have clearly suggested that continents have not been drifted. They have drifted, but the reasons for drifting is not because of gravitational force or polar fleeing force are suggested by Wegener, but there are some more forces where convective currents are there. Convective currents, which those are the ones which have helped in movement. That's what the plate tectonics theory and the seafloor spreading will be saying about. So, continental drift theory, though it has a very significance, why these things have occurred, these forces are not true. Questions have been raised on these two things. How gravitational pull of the moon and polar fleeing force has been done. So, these two were never proven right. So, when Alfred Wegener has suggested this theory, everyone has accepted that yes, continents are drifting. So, what is the outcome? What is the outcome? Outcome is the entire scientifically proven things have agreed that yes, continents are drifting. Continents are drifting. But why are they drifting? That theory could not explain. Or theory failed to explain actual reasons. He was heavily criticized. Failed to explain. In fact, he was heavily criticized. How he was heavily criticized? The following facts, shortcomings. He could not explain why it started 200 million years ago. First of all, he said that 200 million years ago, continents have drifted. As per the first photograph you have seen here, around 200, 250 million years ago, they have drifted. And 200 million years ago, in the Triassic period, you have found that Laurentia and Gondwanal, they started drifting. And in the Jurassic period, slowly the drift has become much more smoother, 145 million years ago. And then in the Cretaceous period, 65 million years ago, there is more resemblance. There still India is located in southern hemisphere. You can see here India, southern hemisphere. And present today, it has came to the original position here. So, one day we'll discuss about geological time scale also. I'll also discuss about geological time scale. So, what is this Cretaceous period? What are this Permian period, Jurassic period? I will tell you the geological time scale. Okay. As of now, you simply understand about these aspects. So, Permian, Triassic, Jurassic, Cretaceous, present day. So, why it has occurred here? Why it is moving here? Why it has significantly moved here? We are finding in the periods it is changing, but some periods it is moving very quickly. Why? We don't know as per this theory. So, what is the theory fails? The theory shortcomings is why it started, how it is moving. Then, oceans are plowed. Seriously, yesterday we have discussed the density of the kind of oceanic crust. Oceanic crust is much denser than continental crust. How can a less dense continental crust less dense continental crust can plow high dense oceanic crust? Oceans are plowed, seriously. Okay, don't write these words in the exam. Oceans are plowed, seriously. You say the theory failed to explain how could continental crust, which is denser, which is less denser than oceanic crust, are able to plow oceans. So, how we can say in simple manner, how the continental crusts are much less denser than heavier than oceanic crust. So, how can less dense crust plow through heavier crust? That's what the things are. So, oceans are plowed? No. This is also could not be explained. And whatever the forces which you are saying, whether it is gravitational force or whether it is the polar fleeing force caused because of rotation of the earth, they are very, very too weak to plow. Too weak to plow. Too weak to plow. So, definitely these forces are very, very weak. Okay. Are you understanding, my dear students, my dear friends? Are you able to understand this aspect? And one of that, the theory also fails to ignore the effects of weathering, erosion and deposition. The exogenetic forces which act on the continents, weathering, erosion, deposition, it's a very, very difficult one. So, what are the shortcomings? These are the shortcomings. Am I clear, all of you? So, what are the shortcomings? It started to, why it started at 200 million years ago, it could not explain. How the oceans are plowed, less denser, heavier, denser. So, please remember these words here. Continental, less denser. Oceanic, heavy, denser. Heavy, dense, oceanic. How can less dense continental can plow heavy dense oceanic? That could not be answered. Forces which are explained by this theory, they could not explain. But still, this theory is regarded as a significant one. In the studies of plate tectonics, in the study of tectonic movement, continental drift theory has a very huge role to play. Otherwise, why would we discuss a failed theory now? Why would you discuss a failed theory now? We will never discuss that. But we are discussing why? Because it is regarded as significant because nobody has explained the reasons of the formation. Nobody has explained that continents are drifting. But this theory has explained it very diligently. That it is still regarded as significant because continents are actually drifting. The word continental drift is true, but the reason why this drift is happening, that is not true as per this theory. So this theory was laid foundations for further studies of concepts like seafloor spreading, plate tectonics theory, which was later developed in 1960s. 1960s, 50s, seafloor spreading, mapping of the ocean floor, the influence of World War II technology, everything has laid foundations for these things. So, that is the thing. So, the first time it has recognized that continental drifts are happening. So, this is the conclusion which we need to answer. Okay. So, am I clear? Now, what is the learning review you had? Let us briefly review whatever we have given you. So, the learning review is, first we have discussed that continental drift theory. So, what is Panthalassia, Pangaea, Gondwanaland, Laurentia? Gondwanaland, southern one. Laurentia, north one. So, how this differentiate has occurred? Which are lands of part? They might ask you MCQ question on that. Then, evidences. What are the evidences which you have discussed? All the evidences will be possible MCQ question. And then next one, the shortcomings. They might ask you the distribution of continents and oceans which were suggested by continental drift have actually explained by plate tectonics. So today topic which you are discussing, there is a continuity tomorrow. So together you should understand how these shortcomings, evidences, continental drift theory has been suggested by basically the remaining aspects. Okay, so they might ask you, what is continental drift theory? How it has failed? And what is its outcome? So the outcome is, it is nevertheless the first theory to suggest about drifting for the first time. Yes. Plough means similar to drifting. Yes. Ploughing means, you see, as per this continent, you see here, how do South America is drifting away? Check that. So, as per this, what is happening? This continent is moving west, right? South America. As it is moving, South America is moving westwards. What it is doing? It is actually drifting. It is plowing across the ocean. It is moving through the ocean, na? That's what we are saying. How can a less denser South American continent can plow through South America? Can plow through ocean? Plowing means here digging across the continental of the across the oceanic landmass. It is moving. How it is happening? That is what you called plow. So you see the word plowing in agriculture. What is it? You are digging the land. How can a landmass, a continental landmass which is less denser, can dig a heavier, denser continental landmass? Can heavier, denser oceanic landmass? That is what is called plowing. Am I clear, Srihari? Am I clear? Okay. So this is about the continental drift theory. Okay. So what will you get from me? So this is about today's learning review. You have learned now. What did you learn? You have learned in detail about continental drift theory. Now what will you get from me regularly? We will be having regular sessions on geography. Mains answer writing is on the way. Tomorrow I will give you around 3 questions. And I will discuss those questions later on. Definitely yes. Tomorrow I will give you the questions. Please remember me if I don't give it tomorrow. Then I will be regularly discussing special classes which are current issues discussion will be there. Regularly that will be done. MCQs practice regularly are done on geography environment. This weekend I am starting with economy MCQs. You can today I will be uploading the schedule in the Unacademy app. You can go through the Unacademy app, download that. Or go to the Unacademy website, go to my profile page, my name Venkatesh Imani. And there you can identify the schedule. So tomorrow and today night, I'll be uploading and you can check the schedule. Then I also am doing subscription courses. Topic wise, previous year questions of entire geography have been done. Tomorrow is the last day. I'm completing that course. So Indian geography will be completed. So you can check that. So entire from 95 to 2019, I have done it everything. You can go and watch those things. Okay. So all these things you can go and watch. Not just that. So this is a subscription course for you. Topic wise previous year questions which I am doing. And once you get subscribed, you will get access to everything. Not just my course, all the courses of all the faculties. And please like this video, comment this about this video, share this video to as many people as possible. Your likes and comments will act as a review for other aspirants. And this will act as a motivation for me also. And share it to as many people. Hemant. Hemant, are you there? Yes. Is it necessary for me to prepare current affairs or 2020-21? If you are going to write UPSC in 2023, you see, for all of you, whoever is asking questions about these things, kindly ask these questions at the end of the session, not in between. Okay, so that I will remember and I also have the time to explain. What is the correlation of continental drift and current affairs? You tell me. So please ask the questions. You will have so many questions. I understand that. So please ask them. I will never stop you to ask. But do ask me only at the end of the sessions. Please get this point clear. But do ask me. I will encourage you to ask more. And I will have the patience to tell also. But not in the middle of a session. Okay. When I am trying to tell you some things, you have to oblige. Right. So current affairs. Should you prepare? I would say yes. But what is it? If you don't prepare right now, how can you understand all these things within a span of 10 months before the exam? Definitely you prepare. For example, you take the recent India-China issues. You will not get this India-China issues clearly unless and until India-China, you will not get this issue clear unless you follow the current affairs now. The present current affairs of India, China, India, Nepal, which you are learning, right? The last 2 months they are in significantly news, which you are learning, will be the static portion later on. And you have to learn about the developments. International relations, it is about current affairs only. Definitely these things will be important even in 2023. So ideally, they will be asking around 18 months. Anything 18 months will be important for prelims. But in general, certain things for understanding some topics you can learn. Hemant, so 23 na? Which year are you planning? 2023. How many years are there now? 21, 22, 23. 3 years. So you can slowly start understanding about the major current affairs. Because current affairs is continuity. Okay, current affairs is about continuity. So definitely you have to practice current affairs. But slowly, you see, understanding the current affairs, grasping them, able to remember, able you to understand. It takes time here. Okay, it is about evolution of knowledge. So I would definitely say that you have to prepare current affairs for the simple reason that knowledge building will not be done on one day. Why? Civil services is a process of knowledge building. This knowledge building can be done only when you start early. So what is the best time to start? Now. What is the best time to start? Now. Why? Because now you will understand everything. As you start, over a period of time, your evolution will improve. You might not remember every fact, but regularly have a curious one. That's why I'm asking you brainstorm. I will do sometimes brainstorm sessions, right? Why I'm doing brainstorming sessions? Because of these things only. Okay. So definitely knowledge building. Now is the time you have to invest time here itself. Okay. And tomorrow, please ask me. I will definitely give you 3 to 4 questions. And I will discuss these questions also next week. I will give you around 5 days time. And you can discuss these questions next week. So please do that. Okay. Like, comment, share about this video. And Hemant, you just ping me your number. Ping me here today. Now itself after the session. Session is completed. Ping me on this number now only. Now. And this is my Telegram channel. Crack UPSC CSC with Venkatesh Himani. You can get into that. There is also a Facebook page. Go into that. Subscribe to us. Link this Facebook page and Telegram channel. Get into that. And please, that's it about today. Thank you very much for all of you for watching. Good evening, Saroj. You came almost exactly at the end of the session. Thank you for watching. Please hit the bell icon for notifications and don't forget to use my code VE10 to get around 10% discount in the subscription, where you will get access to all the awesome courses which are there in the Unacademy planning platform. Okay. So please think about the subscription. Thank you very much for watching. See you tomorrow. Tomorrow is a continuation of this. We will discuss seafloor spreading and plate tectonics theory.